Are you a monthly, weekly, or daily planner type of person? Well, with Notion, you don't necessarily have to use one planner type. This is one of the strong points of a digital planner. In this video, we wanted to give you a tour of our daily, weekly, monthly planner in Notion to show you how it works and how you can make Notion be a versatile planner tool. If you find this useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and click the notification bell. So when you first open up this template, you'll notice various sections. So on this side, we have quick links such as the instructions on how to use this template, daily planner, weekly and monthly planner, and a calendar slash schedule. But these are here mainly so that you can store the databases used in this template. And then on the top, we have our daily planner, and this is where you can make daily plans, and you can see today, tomorrow, this week, and view all. And then in the middle, we have a weekly view of this planner along with a weekly planner. So the weekly planner is where you can plan your weeks. And to see your schedule, you can just look at this week's schedule. And then here we have this month where you can see your monthly schedule as well as a monthly planner. So you can keep track of your monthly goals and review them. So let's go back to the top so that we can examine the daily planner. So when you first start your day, you can just simply click plus new, and it's going to load a daily planner entry with today's date. And you can just simply open this up. And as you can see, we've created a database template that basically creates the daily planner for you. And you can open this up into full page if you want more space to do your planning. So you can fill in your main objectives of the day, look at your week calendar here, and you can fill in today's schedule here as well. So this is a really good way to sort of practice time blocking if you want specific schedules. And then the calendar could be more of your general schedule. So things that you need to remember, like meetings and things like that, you could put in your calendar. But then things like going for walks or what you're going to schedule for each time slot could go in your today's schedule, as well as a quick to-do list here. And then at the end, you can have an end of day reflection if you like. So how did it go? What went well? What could be better? Favorite moment of your day? And what do you hope for tomorrow? So this is just a very comprehensive daily planner sheet that you can choose to use if you'd like to do a daily plan. And let's say that every day your schedule looks similar in terms of your time blocks. You can actually set your default template by going to this blue here. And then you could edit it by clicking here, edit. And if you'd like, you can pre-fill these in and then save it so that every time you load the template, it shows the same thing. So if you always wake up at 8:30, you could just wake up and so on and keep some of the other sections blank. And the other thing we wanted to show you is that if you want this to recur every day at a certain time, you can also click here and then set the repeat here to on, and then it will just show up here every day for you so that you don't have to open it up every day. And at the end of the day, you can just go ahead and do your reflection if you'd like, but that is entirely optional. So next, we're going to go look at our week. So here we have this week's schedule. And if you just want to add schedules here, you can easily just add an item. So let's say that you have a client meeting and you can add tags, for example, if it's work, and a description if you'd like. And then if we go here, you can see client meeting. And if you need to set the time, you can also do so by clicking here and then include time. So let's say the meeting was at 3 p.m. You can just set it like this. And now you can see your schedule like this. And this actually gets reflected also in your monthly schedule as well, like this. So you can really keep track of all of your calendar events across the daily, weekly, and monthly schedule. And then what you can do is when you start the week, you can go to weekly planner and then click plus new. And you can add a start and end date. So let's say that this weekly plan is for this week here, and you want to do end date and then do this. And now we can open this up and see the weekly planner. So with the weekly planner, you have the goals for this week. You can plan your week. So it's basically the same schedule here, but you can do it when you do your weekly planning. And then an end of week reflection, asking yourself, how did it go? What could be better, favorite moments? And what do you want to do differently next week? As well as, did you do everything you wanted? So this is a great way to just start your week by making sure that you have everything set in stone for a really successful week. And then next we have this month. So every time you start a month, you can also go to your monthly planner here, and then you can just click plus new and you can choose the month. So for example, you can type December 2023 and start and end date. You can just add with the same system like this. And then if you open it up, now we have a default template for monthly plans. So you can set some goals for this month, and then you can plan your month and add different calendar items here as you need. Anything important that you should keep track of, you can put in here. And then finally, when you do end the month, you can do an end of month reflection, like how did it go? What could be better? Favorite moments? What do you want to do differently next month? And did you do everything you wanted? So this is a really good way to keep track of your entire calendar across daily, weekly, and monthly systems. So even if you only like to do weekly planning, you could definitely just ignore the daily and the monthly planning sections, but you'll still see your schedule in both the weekly and monthly view like this. So it's just a very versatile planner, and it's definitely a perk of digital planning because you can actually connect your different calendars across different systems. So if you had a physical planner, you probably would have different pages with different information that don't connect. But in this case, you have one central calendar schedule that you can reference no matter if you're daily planning, weekly planning, or monthly planning. So we highly recommend this system. The other thing that we wanted to show you all is that this Notion template comes in every single Notion color. So no matter what color is your favorite in Notion, you'll be able to find a template that matches that for you. So for example, this one is purple. And if we go here, you can see that there are dark modes and light modes for each color set. And there's blue, red, pink, and so on. So no matter what color is your favorite, you should be able to find a planner that suits your needs. So that was our daily, weekly, monthly planner Notion template tour. And if you're interested, we'll leave the link to this in the description below. If you have any questions, comments, or anything that was confusing in this video, feel free to let us know. And we hope to see you in the next one.